Evie Tiedemann here.
And Molly Eley. And we are introducing you to
the fairest of ladies.
My Fair Lady.
Yes, that.
Anyways, My Fair Lady was a jaw-dropping show that first appeared on Broadway in 1952.
March 15th, 1952, to be exact.
Yes. But did you know that the original Broadway cast included Julie Andrews?
I did. Did you know that Audrey Hepburn starred in the movie adaptation that was released in 1964? However, the singing was done by Marie Nixon.
Oh right, Miss Hepburn made large strides to get her voice in peak condition for the part, but she did not end up getting to be as good as the directors were hoping. They decided to go with Marnie Nixon's voice dubbed over Mrs. Hepburn.
The movie, also starring Rex Harrison, won 8 Academy Awards, including the Best Picture Award.
You know what?
What?
You're not a fair lady.
Cue the first song.
It's rather dull in town, I think I'll take me to Barry. The mistress wants to open up the castle in Capri.
Me doctor recommends a quiet summer by the sea. Wouldn't it be lovely?
Is a room somewhere far away from the cold night air with one enormous chair.
Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Lots of chocolate for me to eat, lots of coal making lots of heat, warm face, warm hands, warm feet. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Oh, so lovely, sitting up so blue.
Someone's head resting on my knee, warm and tender as she can be, who takes good care of me. Oh,
wouldn't it be lovely?
That was a great performance by Keenan Piper and Hallie.
Yes, it was. Quite fine.
Loved the harmonies.
Yes, and I really enjoyed the solos as well as the incredible acting.
Fun fact. The Broadway show won 6 Tony Awards, including the Best Musical Award.
And My Fair Lady was based on Pygmalion, a play by George Bernard Shaw.
I am a good girl, I am.
I am a good girl, I am.
Cue the second song.
Bed, bed, I couldn't go to bed. My head's too light to try to set it down. Sleep, sleep, I couldn't sleep tonight, not for all the jewels in the crown. I could have danced all night, I could have danced all night, and still have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never. I'll never know what made it so exciting. to dance with me. I could have danced, danced, danced. All night. I could have danced all night. I could have danced all night. And still have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before. I'll never know what made it so exciting, why all at once my heart took. To dance with me, I could have danced, danced, danced all night.
Then when it was changed, the name came from the nursery rhyme, London Bridge is Falling Down.
During its original run, it set the world record for the longest run date of any show.
The play was adapted by Alan J. Lerner, who wrote the books and lyrics, and Frederick Lowe, who composed the music.
Yes, from the 1913 play Pygmalion by George Bernard Shaw. You already covered this.
Cue the final song.
I have often walked down the street before, but the pavement always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the streets where you live. On the lilac trees in the heart of town, can you hear a lark in other part of town? Does enchantment pour out of every door? No, it's just on the street where you live. And oh, the towering feeling, just knows about me. And oh, the powering second you miss out on me.
that was just amazing.
I would have to agree with you there. Truce?
Truce.
Now let's give a big thanks to all the performers, Keenan, Piper, and Hallie.
And all of our techies, Mr. Collins, Ms. Martinson, Mom Moran, Hunter, and Lizzie.
Thanks for joining me today, Evie.
Thank you for joining me, Molly.
Don't forget to watch the rest of our History of Musical Theater episodes.
See you next time.
Okay. Smash that like button.
And subscribe.